Oh, hello. Welcome back. Just back in the shop having another beer as usual and messing with a few things. This is another one of these Rocky Mountain Strong beer from Fort Garry Brewing. It's pretty good summer beer, actually. And it's alcoholier than normal, too. What is it? 6.5%. So that's kind of fun. Anyway, something that's been bugging me for a while in my shop about my lighting. Several months ago, maybe even a year ago, I built a lighting thing for above my workbench here. And one thing that's been annoying me is the reflections. You can see on here and actually on these guys and on the screens of my meters, you can see the reflections of the individual LEDs up there. Because it's a whole bunch of LED strips. Oh, here, let me show you. There's a view you don't get very often of this place. So it's a piece of sheet metal, just flashing metal, with a whole bunch of cheap LED strips on there, powered off a 12-volt laptop-style supply. And it's got lots of brightness, but this reflection thing is annoying me. So what prompted me to do this is something that I found, a curbside find not that long ago. Let me grab that. It's this thing here, which is, I can't get that all in. It's one of those plastic sheets that's a lighting diffuser that goes on the 24-inch by 48-inch fluorescent light fixtures. If I'm clever, I'll add one in a picture of one in editing. So I'm thinking of using this to sort of tame down what those lights look like and tame down the reflections. So obviously the first step is to cut it down to size so that it fits under here and figure out how to mount it. And I guess I'm gonna have to pull that off too. So let's see how this goes. That sheet that I was telling you about, that's for the diffuser, and I think I'm just going to put it across the middle part of the LED array, because that's the part that that glares. Well, I suppose I could cut a chunk down and put it over the whole thing. What I'm thinking of using to hold it on is just going to suspend it under there using a couple of these little shelf brackets, these kind of slotted shelf bracket things, which are actually the structure on the back of here too. It's just riveted on there. That shouldn't be an issue for holding this thing up, because normally it's just held around the four edges, but I think if I just have couple of pieces like that, it should hold it. So the reason that this thing was getting tossed out by whoever tossed it out is there's a crack in it there and another one over there. So I'll put the part that's not all messed up under here. I'll go about like that and about like that. So how do you cut this stuff? Thing in a practice over here where I don't really care. I wonder if I can just you. Oh yeah. Here we go. Score and snap. Well, that's easy. So before I took this down, I made a couple of marks where the lumber is, the beams, I guess you'd call them, are, and I'm just going to mark those out over top of where my support structure is, so I can drill some holes through there. And I think I'll run screws through this and through the diffuser sheet just to hang it there. I don't think I'm going to do anything too fancy. So here goes. That worked shockingly easy. So just transfer those hole markings. But I noticed that this stuff's kind of fragile and brittle, so I don't think I want to drill it. Oh, where's one of my cutoffs? Easier. What happens if I drill it? Oh, okay. That works. I was half expecting that to shatter. Well, that makes my life easier. I think the trick is to go slow, like fast rip 'ems, but slow push, so that it kind of melt through as much as anything. Okay, so that's how that's going to go. Yeah. It's occurred to me that that diffuser is going to cut back on the light a little bit. So while I got this down here, I might as well add some more LEDs. I'm not going to add a ton of them, just some up the middle here, I think. So that's one thing about video light and even workbench lighting. I mean, you can't really have it too bright. As long as the light's in the right spot and it's not glaring in your eyes, then you shouldn't have a problem with overdoing it, as long as your power circuits can't or can handle it. And for mine, since I'm using this DC power pack, just right now I'm just using a single DC power pack off this end here, which is on my left side when this is actually working on the workbench. I think I'll add a second DC power pack for these extra LEDs. I've just got a couple of wall warts. I'll probably use one of those. And, there's where it's joined. It's soldered. Okay. What have I got here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Can I get a fifth one out of this? I think so. Set that in place. I intentionally left these gaps in between the strips when I built this thing in the first place, thinking that I might want to add more light later, but at the time I didn't have any extras, so I just did it that way. Something that I did the last time that seemed like a good idea, so I think I'm going to do it again, is just put a little bit of Kapton tape underneath the ends where I'm going to solder here, just to prevent shorting out to the metal back. I don't know if it's strictly necessary, but it's just, it seems like a reasonable precaution. So I've stripped up this piece of solid core wire, and just for the to jump all the positives together, and I'll do the same thing with the negatives. Solid core, just because it's a little bit easier to manage. And this is like 18 gauge or thereabouts, so it's way too heavy for this job, but it's what I happen to have. This 22 or 24 gauge, I think, would be a little bit too lightweight. Okay, as you might be able to hear in the background, the laundry started while I'm working on my project here, but we shall persevere. So I've got the red wires soldered down, I've got black wires soldered down, except for I ran out of black wire, so I used to skin some of this red wire back and put some heat shrink on it. Now I'm going to put this this tail, this is just lamp cord, and put one of these things on it, and then we'll reinstall this guy. And I'll save you the background noise. Polarity's right. Yep, 12 volts. Good. Short circuit out of the way. 3, 2, 1, boom. That's nice. Okay, so that's just the middle strip. That's just the new ones that I added. With the other ones, it should be good. Okay, let's clean up this crap and get this thing back where it belongs. All right, that's that in place. Now let's plug in the original lights. They still work. And a bit of cable management over here. Plug in this the new lights on there. Woohoo, that works. Now we'll see how this goes. This is going to be interesting. That makes it better. Seriously, how could I lose a screw in, oh, there it is. There's the fourth one. I don't need this tape anymore. Okay, here we are back in the normal view. Let's see what this looks like. Yeah. Not quite as spotty. It's kind of diffused. I'm getting hot spots off stuff. That looks more like just a flat plane of light rather than a bunch of dots. Let's zoom in on that guy a little bit. Well, there's still some dottiness, but it's a lot more diffuse back there. Okay, I don't know. Was it worth the effort? I'm not sure. I mean, there's more light in the middle of the workbench. That's always a good thing. I guess I'm going to call this a reasonable success. That's the opposite of a failure. So, you know, didn't go horribly wrong. So, I'm going to call it good enough for today. Not sure if that was interesting to a lot of you. I don't know. It's kind of a YouTuber thing to do. And kind of don't want to turn into that guy. But on the other hand, I just wanted to do this project, so here we are. Thanks for watching, those of you who actually made it to the end. I will be back soon with something else. Bye.